Dear students, I am Priyanka Gupta, TGP Science from KV number 3, Sagar. Dear children, this is the time when we used to be in our schools. But these days we are staying at home to fight against the pandemic. To minimize our loss while staying away from school and missing your real classroom teaching, KVSRO Jabalpur has brought you e-learning at your door. Here is an attempt of mine to facilitate your learning of science with some audio-visual presentation. Before we start the lesson, let's enjoy a short clip. Food, shelter, and clothing are the three basic needs of every individual. All the three are equally important. Modifications are there if we want something better. Clothes are also one of them. In the prehistoric era, there has been a drastic change in the clothes that human wear. Early men used the large leaves to cover the body. Even animal skins can be used to cover the body. Soon, animal furs, fleece, and skin are used as clothes, but they are not clothes in true sense. We use plant products to synthesize fine threads, which are woven further into beautiful fabric. I hope you got the idea that what we are going to discuss today. So, students, we'll go through the chapter 3 of science, that is fiber to fabric. Learning outcomes. We'll learn about or get to know variety of fabrics, fibers, types of fibers, some plant fibers, importantly cotton and jute, spinning cotton yarn, yarn to fabric, and uses of jute and cotton in our daily life. Look around yourself. There must be many types of fabric around you. Can you see it? So, do you see your curtains, bed sheets, your cloths, pillow covers, even your doormat? All are there live examples for you of fabric. Can you feel the difference in their clothing material? By touching them, you can feel that they are made up of different types of fabric. See these pictures. They are few types of fabric I have collected for you. Can you identify them? Some of you may be knowing about these, but many of you are still confused. So, in this lesson, we are going to understand about the fiber and fabrics. What do you see here? See any fabric? See any fabric around you? When you look at it, you find a continuous piece, but it is not so. Now let me show you how it is formed.
Piece of cloth. What do you think? This is one piece or made of different threads arranged in a sequence? Okay, let's see. I will try to use one thread from this. is a rug. This loosened thread is called yarn. Now I'll put this thread into a table. By one hand, I'll keep it and scratch by other nails. This thinner, even thinner threads are called fiber. Piece of cloth. What do you think?
So, now by this activity, we know that a loose thread is yarn. You can understand, children? A loose thread is a yarn. बच्चों इसी तरह से हम पाते हैं कि थ्रेड यानी धागे को ही हम यार्न कहते हैं और फैब्रिक यानी कपड़ा यार्न से ही बनता है. नाउ विल मूव वी अंडरस्टैंड दैट व्हाट आर थ्रेड्स व्हाट आर स्ट्रैंड्स and what are fibers. See, here is also a picture of a thread, a yarn, and there are some threads, strands, and even thinner strands, still thinner strands are there. So how can we identify or define the fibers? The thin strands of thread are made of still thinner strands are called fibers. Okay. Now we'll move to the types of fibers. Natural and synthetic fibers. There are two types of fibers, natural fibers and synthetic fibers. As you can feel the difference even by their names. Natural fibers can be obtained naturally. But synthetic fibers are artificial fibers. I am making it more interesting by this video. Let's watch. Fiber, natural fiber and synthetic fiber. We have variety of dresses. What do you think? From where these clothes come? Or how these clothes are made. Dear students, the clothes are made of fabrics and fabrics are made from fibers and fiber is basically a strand made of some material. Have you ever tried to thread a needle? Sometimes the end of a thread is separated into some thin strands. These thin strands are fibers. On the basis of source fibers are two types, natural fibers and synthetic fibers. Natural fibers are obtained from plants and animals. For example, cotton is obtained from plants, wool is obtained from fleece of sheep, hair of rabbit and yarn. The cocoon of silkworm gives us silk fiber. Technology innovation and chemical treatment made it possible to construct fibers artificially. Such fibers are called artificial fibers or synthetic fibers or man-made fibers. For example, rayon, nylon, polyester and acrylic. So, I hope you all have learned about the types of fibers and its examples. Now, we'll learn in this lesson about the fibers obtained by plants that are cotton and jute. See, cotton plants and cotton ball is here. Cotton is a natural fiber. There are the plants of cotton. You can see cotton is obtained from cotton plant. It grows best in black soil and warm climate. Why warm climate? Because it does not need excessive water. इन्हें ज़्यादा पानी की ज़रूरत नहीं होती है. The soil is black and the climate is warm. The cotton plants take more than 60 days to give fruits. The fruits of cotton plant is called cotton ball and they are about the size of a lemon. Cotton best grows in the states of Gujarat, Punjab, Rajasthan, Haryana, Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh and Andhra Pradesh. After getting mature, it bursts. ये बर्स्ट हो जाता है मैच्योर होने के बाद. कॉटन बॉल बर्स्ट होती है और आवाज आती है पॉप. पॉप साउंड कैसे आती है? जैसे हम पॉपकॉर्न बनाते हैं. इसके सीड्स जो कॉटन के अंदर हैं वो हम देख पाते हैं जब ये बर्स्ट होते हैं. देर आर अ लॉट ऑफ सीड्स इन इट. हैव यू एवर सीन अ फील्ड विच इज ओवरलोडेड बाय कॉटन? It looks like a field covered with snow. These are the real cotton fibers. These are the real cotton fibers. They are soft and grown in form of cotton balls. Now we'll see the process of getting cotton fibers from cotton balls. Cotton fibers को cotton balls से कैसे अलग करें, separate कैसे करें? तो we will see the process of ginning. Fibers are separated from these balls and this process is called ginning. The removal of seeds from the cotton balls is called ginning. It can be done by hand and these days mostly by using machines. This is ginning by hand and next picture shows that ginning by machine. In olden days we use ginning by hands but nowadays machines are doing all the work. This is how we make yarn, fiber to yarn. To make fabrics, all these fibers first converted into yarn. We'll see the activity.
I have some cotton ball in my one hand. Now I gently push some cotton from this ball and try to twist it. Now I'm twisting it. To make a yarn. See, this is a yarn. We'll try. Okay. See, this is yarn.
This is the process of making yarn. But this yarn is not so strong as made by machines. They cleaned, washed, combed after ginning. And they become more soft than yarn is prepared. These cotton fibers are converted into yarn and that yarn will make fabric. There are some uses of cotton. See, these are few uses in your daily life. There are many more examples at your own home or in surroundings. You can observe them easily. The other natural fiber that is obtained from plants is jute. These are the jute plants and these are the jute fibers. As you know, We get cotton fiber from fruits of cotton. But jute fiber is obtained from stem of jute plant. Now, the question can be asked like this. From which part of the plant cotton and jute are obtained? So, what will be the answer? Yes, cotton is obtained from the fruits of cotton plant and jute are obtained from the stems of the jute plant. See, here is also some jute plants. You know the states where jute is grown mainly? In India, jute is mainly grown in West Bengal, Bihar and Assam. So, jute is cultivated in rainy season, where cotton is harvested in summer season. When flowers come, the flowering stage come, then we harvest the jute plants. Stems ko cut karne ke baad, unhe stagnant paani mein, ruke hue paani mein dube rehne dete hain kuch dinon tak, wahan stems rotten ho jate hain. और ये प्रोसेस लैटिंग कहलाती है और तब इनको क्रश करके बीट करके ये पील बाहर आ जाते हैं और ये प्रोसेस स्ट्रिपिंग कहलाती है. देन वी गेट दीज स्ट्रॉन्ग जूट फाइबर्स. फर्स्ट जूट मिल वॉज एस्टेब्लिश्ड एट रिशरा ऑन द रिवर हुगली नियर कोलकाता इन 1855. सो हैव यू अंडरस्टूड जूट? Now, see, these are the some uses of jute fibers. As cotton is smooth, so we use cotton in cotton fabric, dresses, cloths, etc. But jute is unlike from cotton. It is rough and strong. So because of its roughness, we use them as gunny bags, shopping bags, ropes and such kind of material which are used for packing. See, here is a cot. Have you seen? Aapke gharon mein cot hogi, isme aapne dekha hoga. Ye jute bhi usi tarah दो तरीके से वीव हुआ है और बहुत सारे मटेरियल्स इससे बने हुए हैं. Nowadays there are so many machines which can be very much smoothen the fibers of jute. So jute cloths are also available. We can also make jute cloths from jutes. You can also make some things from these jute cloths. Have you understood? The other natural fiber is coir. The fiber obtained from the husk of the coconut. It is shown husk of the coconut. These are the husk of the coconut, means upper part of the coconut, which is chiefly used in making rope and matting. These are the ropes made by coir and mat. Okay, have you understood this? Coir. You all have learned and enjoy the session. So, let's discuss what we have learned today. First, we have learned that what is fiber? Reshe kya hai? Second is, what is yarn? Aapko pata hai yarn kya hai? Thread? Yes, whose thread? Jo humne pehle dekha. Types of fibers? ये भी हमने पढ़ा है. टाइप्स ऑफ फाइबर्स, देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ फाइबर्स, यस, नेचुरल एंड सिंथेटिक, एंड दे फर्दर डिवाइडेड इनटू मेनी पार्ट्स. सो नेक्स्ट इज कॉटन. यस, कॉटन इज अ प्लांट फाइबर. यस, वी हैव लर्नड मेनी थिंग्स अबाउट कॉटन. देन जूट. जूट इज ऑल्सो अ प्लांट फाइबर. यस, we have seen the field of cotton and jute also. What is ginning? Next, what is ginning? Kya hai ginning? Separation of seeds from the fibers. Yes, then I tell you about the coir. Coir is also a natural fiber. Okay, so this is revision for you. What we have learned from this session, now you have to answer me. Yes, are you ready? Okay, then. The first question is, which part of cotton is used for making fabric? फैब्रिक बनाने के लिए कॉटन का कौन सा पार्ट यूज होता है? किससे हम फाइबर बनाए कॉटन के? कॉटन का कौन सा पार्ट? यस यस, दिस इज फ्लावर, व्हिच इज आल्सो कॉल्ड कॉटन बॉल्स. सो आंसर विल बी फ्लावर ऑफ कॉटन प्लांट नोन इज कॉटन balls is used for making fabrics or fiber. Next question is, which part of jute plant is used to make jute fibers then fabric? Yes, you all know, I have tell you which part. Yes, this is stem of jute plant. Stem of jute plant is used to make jute fabric. Jute fibers banenge aur phir jute fabric banega. So my next question is, what do you understand by the term ginning? Yes, what is ginning? Tell me. So here is the answer. The process of separation of fibers from seeds. Fibers हमें मिल गए हैं जूट और कॉटन के. अब उसमें से हम seeds अलग करेंगे, तब वो आगे further process के लिए जाएंगे, और this process is called ginning. Okay? Many of you have answering. Yes? Next is, what is coir? See, I have shown you the picture. Yaad aa raha hai kuch? That is also related to coconut. Yes, the answer is the fibers obtained from the husk of the coconut. The upper part of the coconut which gives us fibers, that fibers are called coir. Okay, you have to write these questions in your notebook. I have also taken some exercise questions from NCERT book, that is your textbook. See, here is the page of your exercise book. Try to do it yourself. First we'll discuss it, and you have to do this also in your notebook. First question is, classify the following fibers as natural or synthetic. In first question, what we have to do? You have to classify them. Write first column, that is natural, then write second column, that is synthetic. And observe these which is natural and which is synthetic. It is shown you in the video. Yes, nylon. Which fiber is nylon? Synthetic. Wool. Kis column mein likhenge hum? Natural mein. Cotton. Cotton kis column mein likhenge? Yes, it is also be written in natural fibers. Silk. Silk is also a natural fiber because we get it from cocoon of silk. We'll study this in detail tomorrow. Polyester, it is also a synthetic fiber. And jute is a, yes, natural fiber. We get jute from jute plant. Okay. Now, next is question 2. State whether the following statements are true or false. You have to write true or false after the sentence. First is, yarn is made from fibers. Bataye, yarn fiber se banta hai? Yes, it is true. Fibers are twisted. I have shown you in the activity. They are twisted and will make a yarn from this. Next is spinning is a process of making fiber. Spinning is a process of making fibers. Spinning se fiber banta hai ya yarn banta hai? Spinning se yarn banta hai. Fibers ko jo hum twist karte hain aur yarn banta hai wahi process kya kehlati hai? Spinning. So is it true or false? It is false. Jute is the outer covering of coconut. Yes. What will be the answer? True or false? Jute hai outer covering coconut ki ya coir? Yes, it is coir. So, this is false. Jute is the outer covering of coconut. What we have to write here? False. The process of removing seed from cotton is called ginning. गिनिंग आपको समझ में आया था? क्या था? सीड्स को सेपरेट्स कर रहे थे कॉटन फाइबर्स से. तो क्या है? द प्रोसेस ऑफ रिमूविंग सीड इज गिनिंग. यस, इट इज ट्रू. सिल्क फाइबर इज ऑब्टेन फ्रॉम द स्टेम ऑफ अ प्लांट. सिल्क फाइबर, सिल्क कहाँ से मिलता है? अभी भी मैंने बताया आपको क्वेश्चन वन में, सिल्क वी गेट फ्रॉम cocoon of silk worm. So it is false. Polyester is a natural fiber? No. Polyester is a synthetic fiber. It is also we have seen in question 1. Next is question 3. Fill in the blanks. Very easy. You can also do it. I know you are giving the answers from there. Plant fibers are obtained from, yes, cotton and jute. Animal fibers are obtained. What are animal fibers? They are silk and wool. So the last question is, from which parts of the plant cotton and jute are obtained? I have described this question in the slides also and given you the answer. So you know the answer that cotton is we get cotton from cotton fruit and jute from jute stem. Okay children? I hope it could be fruitful for you all. That's all for today. We'll meet in next class with the remaining topics of this chapter. Till then, enjoy your time and revising. Keep revising the lesson. Take care of yourself in this tough time. Stay home. Stay safe.